Hi, this is Mark from M Solar Power with another quick solar update. In this video, I'm just going to chat you through understanding your solar Xbox during load shedding or emergency power mode in solar X terminology. At the moment, our house is drawing 200 to 400 watts and our battery is at 100% state of charge. If your battery is at 20% state of charge, it's going to shut your system down. And I have another video which I'll link to below, which is going to show you how to adjust your battery capacity to change your stance for load shedding. So at the moment, if the grid goes down, which it's going to nicely do for us now, the system is basically switched off and you could see the lights go off in the garage and you heard those magnetic contactors kick in, and basically our system has changed over to EPS mode and the lights in the garage have come back on. What happens though in this mode, we have a 4.6 kilowatt load limit. So if we add load to the system and overload the inverter, it's going to shut down to self-protect itself. So if you just give me a moment, I'm going to switch on some loads to overload the system. So we're just going to add some load to the system by turning on the kettle. And immediately you can see the load in the house go up to 2,400 watts. And the solar has increased production to actually try and meet this load and draw as little power out of the battery as possible. So if we add some more load, you'll see the load in the house will go up, and we're just going to add another heavy load appliance and just give it a second to kick on. And we're still at 2,500 watts. And now we're going to turn on the oven to try and overload the system. There it goes to 4,300 watts with the oven on, and we need one more appliance. What have you got? Okay, there we are at 5,000 watts, so we're currently overloading the system, and we're waiting for the inverter to shut down. Not overloading, you need to turn something else on. A heater or something? And there we go. We've overloaded the system. So what we need to do now is to go and switch off the items that have overloaded the system. So we've gone around and switched off the heavy load appliances. And basically you can see here the inverter says it's in fault mode. So if you come to the screen and you can see the inverter says overload fault. If we touch this little red asterisk, you can see it will reset the inverter and boop, the loads are still there and we overloaded it again. So we've shut down even more of the heavy items and we're going to hit the restart again, and the system basically restarted and has switched the house back to EPS mode. So you can see we currently were running at 1,400 watts and back to 400 watts. So during load shedding, the most important thing is to only use one heavy load item at a time. If your system goes down on changeover, it's because all of the loads in your home come on at the same time as the inverter switches over to EPS mode. So it's best to go to your DB board, switch everything off, and then power your light switch back on. Then come and reset the inverter and then bring the loads back slowly one at a time to make sure that you don't overload your system. So thanks for tuning in, and I wish you many happy years of being empowered by the sun.